Welcome back. Our next guest scored 93 career playoff goals and got his name on the Stanley Cup 6 times as a member of the Oilers and the Rangers. He was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 2008, Glenn Anderson. Welcome to the show.
Thanks, Heidi.
How are you?
Everything's good.
Very good. Well, Mark Messier said it a few years ago, but do the Pittsburgh Penguins remind you at all of the young Oilers team you were on?
A little bit. They've got a lot of punch and firepower, which is great, and a couple of guys that are chipping in on the outside, which is awesome. They've really come together as a team from last year.
Well, last year, as we know, they lost in the final, just as Edmonton did back in 83. Then Edmonton went on the following year to win. What did you take away from that experience, and what do you think that the Penguins will have to do or will take away from what they had last year?
Right now, I think Crosby and the team is saying everything right and doing everything perfect right to a T. And he's got, he's like a stealth bomber right now. He's saying right things to the right media. He's not complaining about the game whatsoever. He's going out there doing his job, and it looks great, and the team looks really good.
So mature for a 21-year-old. Hey.
Absolutely. I mean, I think he's got a good mentor there with Mario, and I think he's really come a long way in 1 year, and it's amazing the way he just, you know, no matter what I call it outside noise, there's always, and it's going to get tough at some point in time in the playoffs for him, probably in this next series, especially when you're going for the finals. And that outside noise gets very disturbing, and it's how you control that and how you keep your team focused at what the job is at hand.
Well, you mentioned Detroit. If we should get a rematch of last year's final, who are you taking? What do you think?
Well, Pittsburgh is definitely hot right now, but it seems like Detroit always comes up with a way to win, and the way both teams are playing right now, it's going to be a great, great final. And as I just hope it goes the distance, because there's nothing more exciting than a Game 7 in the Stanley Cup Final.
Agreed. Well, you were so good with the game on the line. Did you, you know, in those overtime games, did you call for the puck more? Or was that just the way it ended up?
I think they wanted to give it to me.
They wanted to give it to you to see if you could do it.
Well, they knew I had the capability.
You could do
so
it.
It was like, and I thrived on that. So
you
the tougher
it.
The game, and the more pressure, the more I came to play. And I loved those moments in time. And some players really cherish them and enjoy them and take them on, because it's like something you've practiced your whole life for. But the thing is, that it's how you practice it. So you got to put yourself in that moment in time with basically your eyes or your ears, because the noise is so loud you can't hear the guy calling for the puck. So it's basically either you're waving your stick or you're trying to get someone's attention, or you're kind of your head's on a swivel and you're looking around to see where the rest of the team is. And I think that's important, that your teammates rely on you and you rely on your teammates, and you come all together as one, and that's become how you become a champion. It's not individual efforts.
Common trust. Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for joining us here today. We really, really appreciate it. When we come back, we're going to head out to Detroit for a report on tonight's Game 5. The Cisco All-Access Pregame Show is going to continue right after this.